the plains of Strotham, the absolute evil continued its efforts to free Talia. The trail led it to the vicinity of the city of Strotham, which was once besieged by undead.
These sequences with me in a cage are being stretched out far too long here. Can't we talk this out somehow? Maybe rock, scissors, paper, like in the old days?
Huh. You know I always go for the good old rock. But speaking of stones, I will soon have all the stones of finitude together. And then...
Nobody gives a damn about your stupid marbles, you dumbass.
While Talia was engrossed in an animated discussion with her stepbrother, the brain-eating evil was already attempting a, more or less, fruitless attempt to free her. Since undead simply resurrected somewhat later in the graveyard after their demise, an unsuccessful onslaught was no great tragedy. Admittedly, the creature wasting evil probably never took the loss of subordinates too tragically in the first place. But back to the subject at hand. Fortunately, there were ancient mausoleums in the vicinity, which were home to powerful undead and could provide a significant supply of reinforcements. The map studying evil eagerly took notes.
See that, Tristan? My armies will free me. Go on, you undead! Knock them down! Eat their brains! Just do something.
A temple with a sacrificial pit would need to be built before the merciless evil's undead creatures could summon more minions. Quickly, the construction-obsessed evil set about doing just that. The frivolous evil had erected a temple. From now on, blight could be stored there, which would greatly enhance the ode to grave-wearing evil's undead armies. Thank you.
Payday.
It seems your creatures don't even dare to leave the underground, Talia. But they are not safe there either. Forward, men! Destroy the dungeon in the underground!
There are enemies in your dungeon. payday. The sacrificial eagle had a temple built complete with a sacrificial pit. The greedy-looking black maw, with its dark void, seemed to be eagerly awaiting offerings. Presumably, the evil spirits would reward each sacrifice with some soothing blight. The experimental evil set about testing this theorem. With a Wilhelm scream, a little snob disappeared into the depths of the sacrificial pit. This would provide the little snob-burning evil a bit of blight. Strengthened by the captured blight, one of the undead creatures was able to summon a minion to its side. The extravagant evil was satisfied to note that its undead were able to use blight and minions to maximize the number of creatures that could be used carelessly. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. It seemed as if the sacrificial pit would belch satedly, were it not simply an inanimate object. The sacrificial evil had sacrificed enough things for the time being. It was time to go on the offensive. Enemies are in the dungeon.
It's payday.
Some evil welcomed a bone lord into its ranks. Not only could this mighty swordsman both dish it out and take it, but could also summon skeletal mages as minions. Oh. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there.
Thank you.
In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. The dungeon heart is being attacked. One of the undead creatures that had fallen in battle had gone to rest in the graveyard, only to rise again after some time had passed. The merciless evil was then able to send it back into battle. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. day, creatures are collecting their pay. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. The colorful clothes-wearing evil had discovered a dungeon gate in the underground. Apparently, this was one of the three lost burial chambers. All that was needed to benefit from it was to open the burial chamber, presumably with a few firm blows. This was apparently the final resting place of the legendary mercenary army, the Scallywag Ragtags. The pragmatic evil was bound to have an idea as to what he could do with the undead found there. The zombie-like evil had unleashed powerful undead forces. The use of these powers meant each of its undead creatures could both move faster and summon an additional minion to its side. Each additional burial chamber would provide one additional minion. Payday. Creatures are collecting their pay. Undead forces roamed the land. Additional minions now stood available. Enemies are in the dungeon. meant, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. Enemies are in the dungeon. Powerful undead forces allowed additional minions to rise from their graves. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there.
Day.
fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. Poking around Eagle, had discovered another burial chamber. Enemies are in the dungeon. This tomb was dedicated to the archers of the Scallywag Ragtags. Legend has it that they could miss a barn door even at 10 meters. Their corpses would certainly be put to good use by the self-sacrificing evil. Enemies are in the dungeon. Creatures are collecting their pay. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there. Thank you.
my subjects, I mean brave creatures, already appearing on the horizon. Once they get their hands on you, that summer camp will seem like a lovely vacation compared to that.
My men will stop that vermin. My brothers! In your eyes, I see the same fear that would lead me...
What? That same old crap again? Good grief! Can't you just steal something else? Maybe you should follow Ned Stark's example a little more. That would be a blessing for everyone involved.
The achievement Accumulating Evil had now discovered the third burial chamber as well. The remains found here were those of the alchemists of the Scallywag Ragtags, who considered arsenic to be a refreshing mouth gel. These corpses would prove perfect vessels for mindless zombies.
It's payday.
Undead forces roamed through. Additional minions now stood available. Enemies have entered the dungeon. Powerful undead forces allowed additional minions to rise from their graves. In fact, the sacrificial pit was a very versatile contemporary. Pretty much everything could be thrown in there.
My armies are getting closer, little brother. Want to go ahead and pick out a nice tombstone? Not that you'll need it when I put your head on a spear.
We do not need to further elaborate on your misdeeds, sister. My armies are not yet defeated, and the hero's courage is unbroken.
The courage may be unbroken, but the spine...
Ding dong! It's payday!
The vile stench of the undead is still coming ever closer. Forward, faithful! Destroy that vermin!
Problems, brother mine? Is that the sweat of fear I can see on your brow? This reminds me of when you were going to ask Chelsea Chubby Cheeks to prom.
That's not the point here.
And she dumped you because she wanted to take her dog for a walk instead.
The Sovereign Evil had freed Talia from the clutches of her stepbrother. Pity, really. I found it quite pleasant not to have someone constantly interrupting me.
I will ignore your insolence for now. But only because I have to deal with that damn Tristan. The step in stepbrother is going to be an architectural statement when I'm done with him.
Lost in her rant, Talia had missed the fact that her stepbrother Tristan had meanwhile made a run for it.
What? That cowardly, dishonest, disgusting,